At least once you have been unsure what kind of glass to use and what parameter to set in your renderings with Wimotion. In this video I'll explain everything you need to know about the glass material as well as explain its characteristics. Plus, I'll tell you what values to use to make the most of it. First of all, the glass material is divided in three types: basic, standard and colored. I anticipate right away that the basic category is oversimplified and has many limitations in its controls, so I won't even consider it. Using the PathRacer engine, in most cases you will use the standard type, which is suitable for simple transparencies since it handles reflections and refraction well. The colored, on the other hand, is mainly used for colored glass or colored drinks, such as wine, cola or something like that. The main characteristics of a glass are opacity, which determines the degree of translucency of the material. Low values correspond to very transparent glass. As the value increases, the glass will tend to become opaque. Fresnel opacity, which adjusts the transparency depending on the viewing angle. The higher the value, the more realistic the glass will tend to be. And finally, roughness, which, modified together with opacity, manages the softness of the glass. Higher values make the glass satin. In addition to this, however, it is crucial to carefully choose the type of glass from Twinmotion's library. The main ones are clear glass, which is certainly simpler and more widely used, although it does not handle refractions, and Eton glass, which returns more pleasing and realistic results because it handles refractions more accurately. The final choice, therefore, seems to go in the direction of the Eton glass, but it all depends on the 3D model on which the material is applied. On elements such as glasses and bottles, Eton glass certainly has a more pleasing effect, but on simpler surfaces such as window and door glasses, clear glass is more suitable as it is lighter and easier to handle in terms of rendering time. The values to use are up to your discretion, but personally I leave opacity at low values, between 0 and 10 for iron glass, and between 5 and 15 for clear glass. Roughness at 0 for maximum reflection, Fresnel opacity always at 1 for better material quality. To the end with PathRacer, colored material are the only ones that properly handle colored shadows, which are essential for colored glass, liquids in a bottle or glass, but unfortunately caustics are currently still not handled the best. For this, in case you want to increase the detail, you can add caustics manually. Download from the web black and white images with the effects you prefer. Insert into Twinmotion a decal, replace the texture of the color with the download one. If necessary, apply an opacity mask using the same texture. Scale it to the right size, activate emissive character to give it light, and change the color to your liking. For this trick, I can only thank the great Luca Rodolfi, master in the use of Twinmotion and moderator of the Twinmotion official community group on Facebook, which has over 120,000 people. Sign up to connect with me and the entire Twinmotion community. Changing rendering engine, although Lumen has been greatly improved with latest versions, it still cannot handle reflections nor colored or transparent shadows to the fullest extent. In my opinion, the best glass that can be used with the Lumen engine for complex glasses turns out to be iron glass, as it handles reflections and transparencies very well. And for simple surfaces, clear glass is always convenient. In conclusion, glass can also be optimized and detailed with imperfections along the surface to create effects such as dirt, fingerprints or driven rain. To do this, you either insert a texture in the roughness and normal parameters with the desired effect, and again, you can choose from the many textures available online. Or, if you prefer, you intervene directly on the automatism that Twinmotion provides in the imperfections menu, in particular by changing the amount and size of the fingerprints, or by intervening in the same parameters but for the dust. Thank you so very much for watching this video. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future content, like the video so you can help me with the algorithm, and suggest me in the comment what topic you'd like me to cover in the next video. That said, I wish you a good day or evening and see you very, very soon. Ciao!